Hey everyone, if you have two or more computers, Raspberry Pis or home servers, you might not want to haul around your monitor, keyboard or mouse everywhere around your house every time you need to check something's full on one of them. It's frustrating and it can take a lot of time. So I recently went looking for a solution for this myself because I have my main PC but also have my Homelab NAS over there. I worked out there's actually 9 different methods of using the same keyboard, monitor and mouse to control them. Well, actually it's more like 20 different methods, but I'll cover the 9 different types of methods in this video and I'll then naturally mention all the different products you can use along the way. So the standard way that you can use the same keyboard, monitor and mouse to control multiple devices is to buy what's known as a KVM switch. With these, you plug your common USB devices like your wired keyboard and mouse or wireless USB controller into it, and then you plug your output monitor into them, basically whatever display you want to use. You should then run a USB cable from all of your devices to the KVM switch, so the switch can then control all of them. And finally, you run HDMI or DisplayPort cables to your devices too, from the KVM switch. This then means that you can simply press a single button and you can control all your other devices straight away. The keyboard, mouse and monitor will magically switch to the other device. Awesome, right? Well, yes it is, when it works. I did actually try out a budget KVM switch with my setup, which includes a Windows 11 main PC and also a Debian Homelab NAS, and the switch worked fine for my Windows PC, but not my NAS. Debian just kept refusing to show the display output properly. Plus every so often Windows would corrupt and only show everything in 1080p even though this is a 4K monitor. One time I actually had to reinstall all my display drivers to solve this. Now, this is partly my fault for buying a budget KVM switch. Many more premium switches are more reliable, especially if they support EDID emulation. EDID introduces some extra technologies so that the process of display output switching is smoother and hopefully more reliable. I say that if you were going to try out a KVM switch, go in with a reputable brand like AV Access or Texmart might make sense, but do please read the reviews yourself in case they don't work for you for whatever reason. You'll probably find that whilst these work for many people, for other people, they simply don't. And that's the slightly annoying thing with KVM switches. The actual technology is cool in theory, but in practice it can be a bit buggy too. Now, before we move on to other solutions, I should point out that running USB and HDMI cables between different computers might not always seem practical, especially if they're in separate rooms after all. Some of the other approaches I cover in this video don't actually require running separate cables, so stick around for them. But what you could also do is run cables up into your attic, which I cover in another video, or you could simply run the cables along your skirting board, which is usually easy enough. But you do need to think about how you run your cables with these first few methods. This brings me on to the second method for controlling multiple devices. Some monitors actually have KVM functionality built into them, which is pretty neat. For example, these monitors from Gigabyte, LG and Philips all allow you to plug in your mouse and keyboard and then use a USB-C cable from each of your devices to use the monitor itself for the KVM switch control functionality. And that's pretty cool. This is often a more reliable approach too than using a budget KVM switch, plus it has the benefit of needing less wires overall. You don't have a separate switch, and you don't need to run extra HDMI or DisplayPort cables everywhere, which can get messy very quickly. Quite a few higher-end monitors are starting to offer KVM functionality, and that's pretty cool, but I mentioned these three specific monitors earlier because I know people who have actually used this mode and it works well with them. The next solution you can try is a bit of a halfway house. Your monitor will naturally allow you to plug multiple cables into it, so you can simply run display cables like HDMI or DisplayPort from different computers and then plug them straight into your monitor. You can then use the standard input switch-in menu to actually switch between them. But what about the keyboard and mouse? Well, good question, Tristan. Basically, what you could do is use a wireless keyboard and mouse combo, and these can be powered with a simple USB adapter. So when you want to switch to another device, just move your USB over there. Simple. Yes, it does require getting out of your seat, but this is a low-tech solution that often works really well and reliably, especially if your other device is in the same room or in the next room or something like that. Plus, if your monitor supports auto-switch source, then it's even better because you don't actually need to mess around with your monitor's input menu at all. You can just move the USB adapter to your other device and your monitor should recognize this and then switch the output to that. It's really simple, and I actually did use this method for a few weeks, but there's 5 other methods that might work out better for you, especially because it's not always practical to physically move a USB adapter around your house to a new device, or maybe you just hate wireless keyboard and mice, which I don't really blame you if so. I do lots of video editing and wireless mice just tend to lag a bit too much for my liking. In this case, you can buy a USB switching device, basically a KVM switch, but it doesn't support monitor output. It only switches USB control from one device to another. So you'd run a USB 3 or USB-C cable from each of your devices and then plug them into this USB switch. You then would plug in your common devices like a mouse, keyboard and a webcam, and it's all ready to go. When you need to move to another computer, you would simply press a single button on the USB switch and all your devices move over to the new PC. Once you've changed the monitor display output, if it doesn't automatically switch over, that is. So while admittedly you do have two different things to do, unlike a monitor KVM switch where you just have a single button and then everything changes, this can be quite a good approach. This is pretty much the method I've ended up going for, although admittedly I've gone one step jankier and actually use a static USB hub and then a manually switch which USB 3 output the hub should control by literally moving the cable around. But that's mainly because I like my anchor hub, it works fine, and I didn't really want to shell out more cash on a USB hub with a button when I had something that I was already happy with. While USB switches can work well, there's a few other neat alternatives that are really worth knowing about. Firstly, Logitech have a pretty cool bit of technology that they call Unifying. It's a nice name. With that, you plug a single USB adapter into one of your devices, and then you can pair your Logitech keyboard and mouse to it. In fact, up to 6 keyboard and mouse if you want to go crazy. You can then install some Logitech software on your other computers, and they can share the same keyboard and mouse. So that's pretty cool, and it should work in some cases, but there's a few downsides. First, you have to buy all Logitech devices for this, plus it's more designed to work with a notebook or a laptop, being able to move your laptop around the house and then sit down at a desk and start using the keyboard and mouse there, without needing to mess around with finding the right USB adapter for that keyboard and mouse and then plugging it into your laptop. But if you want to be sat at one desk and control 5 different computers, for example with the same hardware, with the same monitor, keyboard and mouse, then Logitech Unifying probably isn't the right choice. And that brings us on to the final 4 methods, and none of them require you running HDMI or USB cables all around your house and making a mess, which is a bonus. Firstly, you can use what's known as software KVM, which basically allows you to share your keyboard and mouse over the network via Wi-Fi or Ethernet. The way this works is you install software on both computers, or multiple if you've got more than 2, you can then often press a certain keyboard button or move your mouse to the edge of the screen, and this then will switch the control to your other device or devices. You will still need to change your monitor output, of course, but this can be quite a neat solution. In terms of what software to use, there's absolutely loads of choice, which I show on screen now, and I also mention whether they only support Windows or whether they support Mac and Linux too, which can be a nice bonus. Software like Mice Without Borders is arguably the best choice here if you run Windows on all your PCs, because this was actually created by a Microsoft employee, and you can download this for free from Microsoft's own website. On the other end of the spectrum though, you have Synergy, which is paid for, but it supports Linux and Mac too. So this can be a really great solution if you have slightly more complicated computer setups in your house or your office. There are a bunch of other options though, and some have free and paid plans, while others are just paid for only. Software KVM can be a pretty cool solution, especially because they often allow you to share the clipboard between both systems, basically meaning you can then copy text on one system and paste it onto another, even if you're switching between Windows and Mac, for example. So that's neat, but there's 2 downsides to be aware of. Firstly, since these are software solutions, they won't work when your system is booting up. For example, they won't work when your system is shown a grub bootloader or when you want to go into the BIOS menu. Secondly, because this works over the internet, you ideally need a rock-solid internet connection. Using slow or unreliable Wi-Fi will often result in lots of input lag with your mouse and your keyboard, which can become really annoying really quickly. So the 7th way of controlling multiple devices with the same monitor and keyboard setup is to explore RDP, Remote Desktop. This is where you enable or install software within your various computers, and then you can jump into one of them from your main PC. Windows actually has built-in remote desktop software, allowing you to operate the other computers though you're really there, which is cool. I used to use this a lot in a previous job if we needed to quickly remote into our work computers in the night to check something or change something when we were home. There are, however, lots of different remote desktop programs out there though, with TeamViewer, Rust Desk, and AnyDesk probably being the most popular options, and they all offer free versions for personal use, but then a range of different paid-for plans for companies to get some extra features. The next option is to look at command line control of your systems, which naturally will work if you plan on gaming or video editing from another PC, but this does work really well for basic monitoring, installing certain programs, and general system management. To do this, you need to enable an SSH server on the other computer, and then you download an SSH client on your main PC, such as PuTTY or Mobrax Term. You then create a new SSH session, entering the IP address of your other PC or other PCs, along with the username and password, and then you can connect to that other system. You can then manage the other computer as much as you would like, and this is mainly what I do to control my Homelab NAS over there, which runs Debian most of the time. It's just a really simple process. Now, traditionally, this SSH method wouldn't have easily worked with Windows, but in recent years, they've actually added SSH support too, so you can actually SSH into your Windows box from somewhere else. Though, granted, you then have to relearn all the weird Windows commands, for example, entering dir and not ls to list, but that's not a major problem, and SSH can be really good if you're not doing GUI-type work. but my final method to actually mention, my ninth one, is to explore KVM over IP. As the name suggests, this offers KVM input switching type functionality to reuse your monitor, keyboard, and mouse on other computers. But this is designed to work over the network, and you achieve this by plugging a device into your other computers, and this then gives you full control of the other device from your main system. Because this can actually be run over the network, this introduces a really cool benefit, because you can use KVM over IP to control computers anywhere in the world. Just install a KVM over IP switch in your friend's nuclear submarine and you're golden. Okay, maybe not, but this is still a great technology with two main downsides to know. Firstly, because you're buying a separate device and that device has lots of powerful and cool features, it's kind of expensive, with many KVM switches costing many hundreds of dollars or pounds. Secondly, some of these switches won't actually work with boot up control, like logging into the BIOS. You'll then need out of band management features on the switch, such as, I think, Spider KVM offer this and some more enterprise KVM switches, but these are more expensive again. I'd love to know what method you use to actually control all the different devices, so please let me know down in the comments. I personally use a mix of SSH and then manual monitor and USB switching to control my Homelab NAS, since these are most reliable and lowest cost options. And I show off more information about this, including some of the issues I faced along the way, in another video if you wanted to check that out. But I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.